I've got some exciting things to show you. I'm working on a new robotics project. This is what I have so far. It's two wheels on an axle. Inventive stuff, I know. But I'm actually pretty impressed with myself, because I'm not used to 3D printing things with such high tolerances, as high a tolerance you can get with FDM 3D printing. Today on HackBatch, I'll be exploring what it takes to design and build a robotics drive assembly from scratch. First, let's take a look at the previous robot, HB2O. It had a tendency to tip forward when decelerating due to the large amount of mass from the motors above the pivot point. To eliminate this, Goblin's design will be much more low profile. I wanted to use these wheels from the previous robot that I built, HB2O. The shaft that came out of the gearboxes from the previous robot was 17 millimeters, which is not a standard size. So instead of buying a piece of steel that was 17 millimeters and cutting the keyway myself, I decided to 3D print some keyed bushings that would hold bearings on either side of the wheel. I did some testing to see what would give me the best press fit on a bearing, as well as a good friction fit inside of the keyway. Once I had the wheels turning on the axle, I could turn my attention to this drive assembly. To make this work, I would need to design and print a GT2 pulley. Turns out, this is one of those things that's easier said than done. It took me a few hours of tinkering to get something that was parametric, which means that I can type in any number of teeth and the pulley will change size and shape to match, keeping the tooth profile exactly the same. The pulley went through a few more redesigns before it was final, and I tested it many times in between. Next, I needed a way to attach the motors to the assembly. I went through three different iterations of the design before I landed on this one. The first version of the H-bracket included these holes on the sides, which would allow me to move the motor mount up and down. I included this in the design because I didn't know exactly how far the pulleys needed to be apart in order to keep the belt tight. The final design features two M3 screws and embedded nuts that pull the motor bracket towards the top of these slots. This tensions the belt and keeps everything in place. And of course, those slots needed revision too. I had to bulk them up quite a bit before they were able to hold the motor bracket in place. To make assembly and repair much easier, I decided to change out the embedded bearings for these pillow blocks. They have built-in collars to keep them attached to the axle and sit flush with the edge of the 3D print. After a lot of back and forth and sketching of what I wanted the robot to look like, I decided on something that was much more narrow in proportion, and that would require changing the axle to a smaller size. With the correct axle selected, it was time to test fit all of these 3D printed parts. One of the first tethered tests of Goblin. Should start here in a few seconds. So far, I've got a very early prototype of this robot. I'll be documenting my process over on hackbatch.com as well as here on YouTube. To follow Goblin's journey to becoming a fully-fledged robot, you can subscribe here on YouTube and on HackBatch.com. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.